Described Entertainment Tonight, I think, described it as a cross between Downton Abbey and then Game of Thrones, that action being thrown in there together. Accurate, or would you find a better way to describe the show?
Yeah, I think that's probably quite accurate. The amazing thing for me was how modern that world was at that time, like when we were reading the initial scripts, to find out that people like Philippe existed in that world, and the other people that surrounded this incredible king at that time, they really existed. It will really feel like you're watching something
you're
that's present there.
So this is a huge step forward for you, time-wise.
A few hundred years, yeah. A few hundred years. But it's quite a different show, you know. It's very, very modern in comparison to Vikings.
Alex, I will ask you this because you seem to be involved with everyone in this show, and I do mean everyone in this show.
Rightly or wrongly, yes.
How does it all break down? I mean, we have a lot of relationship drama in this
There's
show.
There's a lot
well.
Of relationship drama, especially between these two. So I'm the king's brother, but this is my beautiful wife. But Philippe is an open homosexual. He has a boyfriend called the Chevalier. These two, well, Henriette is the king's mistress. So this is like the first sort of proper European dysfunctional family.
So you guys are getting a little bit going on here.
It's complicated. It's not black and white. Let's just say that. Yeah. So no, it's good, and it's so much fun to play. And they're very three-dimensional characters. The whole scope of the show is, you know, it's an epic drama. It's huge.
One of the things that stands out, not just the historical part of this, but just, I mean, the beauty of it. And you look at Versailles. I was fortunate. My parents took me when I was maybe 12 years old to go to Versailles. And I still remember the grandeur, the beauty, to see that on screen, plus the costumes and everything. That had to be just, I mean, it has to be a thrill to just be a part of it. But I'm sure it's a lot of work, too, getting ready and everything.
Oh, yeah. Especially these two, because they have beautiful wigs.
The wigs and everything, right.
They look amazing. And I had five beautiful dresses that were perfectly my size and were made for me. The costume designer is amazing. She designed every character with a type of color and a style, very typical. It was beautiful. And also, I didn't know that there were so many castles around Paris that were so beautiful. And, you know, they were actually the same.
Because we got to film there. And also,
I was going to ask, Alex, so you actually film in the palace itself, right?
We get to film in Versailles, which is closed to the public on Monday. So we get to film inside there. And then we have this amazing thing in Paris where they're kind of the compasses, the castle compasses. There's a castle in the north, there's a south, there's one in the east and the west. And we take different parts of like a corridor from one castle, the gardens from another, and that ends up becoming what we see in the show. So we're very lucky. I mean, it's an amazing job. We count our lucky stars that as actors of our age to get to film in places like this. It's amazing.
George, we see so many TV shows here in the US that it seems like after it's already made it somewhere in Europe, then it finally comes here to the United States. I don't know if that's a compliment or not, but it looks like this might be another one. How do you do you do things differently for a US audience as opposed to a international audience?
I don't think so, but it has been fascinating watching the different international reception of this show. And I think we're most excited about how the US are going to receive it, because it is very, very topical and very modern. And I think, We love watching that world and those people, and I think the US audience are going to as well.
We don't change the type of how we're filming it for a particular audience. We try and treat the show with the truth and the respect that it deserves. And luckily in Europe, it's been lapped up, and also in the UK, everyone's loved it. So it kind of feels like about time that the US are finally getting to see this show, you know?
So obviously we're dealing with a historical accuracy when it comes to the palace, when it comes to characters. How historically accurate do we keep this story, or do we take a lot of creative licenses here?
I would say 90%, because there's always like a romantic aspect, and you know, the relationship between the king and Henriette, for instance, wasn't very, in historical books you can't find proof that it existed, but they were very close. So you know, the showrunners wanted a little drama, and I think that was like the middle between what we think it could be and what it actually was.
How do you prepare for something like this?
Oh, we read a lot.
Yeah.
Well, you read a lot.
You just went with
it.
Read a lot.
No, I don't know. I just come from that sort of...
Like, I'm going to mess with everybody on the show. I'm just going to throw myself in the middle of everything.
The showrunners studied this period in history, so as actors, it's amazing going onto a set knowing that you have that creative.
And we trust the script, you know. We come from that school of acting that the script is the Bible. You know, you go from what the showrunners and what the writing is giving you. You can can, you know, take as much books and rush research in as possible. How much of that transforms onto screen, I don't know. So, I mean, I speak for myself here. I'm not putting these two under the blanket. They probably did as much research, but for me, not so much.
We had a historical consultant on set all the time, so we could ask a lot of questions to him, too, because he's a specialist about Versailles.
Well, here's the fantastic news for folks at home. We told you you're going to be obsessed with it, and you're going to have not one season, but more to go, because you guys have already wrapped a couple of seasons already, right?
We've just finished season 2 in July.
So we have much more to come this year, and you're going to get to spend the day here in Washington today. Welcome to our great city, by the way.
Thank you very much.
What are you going to do?
We're going to go to the French embassy tonight, and we're going to show episode 1 to a bunch of important people, as I've been told. And then tomorrow we go to...
New York.
We fly to New York tomorrow. Mm. And then and we've got a couple there until the launch, which is on Saturday.
Well, George, Alex, Noemi, we appreciate you all coming here today, taking some time out of your busy day here in Washington, and we'll be watching for you. The show is actually going to start October 1st. You can catch the episode. It will be on Ovation TV, and as you're going to have to get used to it, because you're going to see a couple of series worth of it so far. Thanks, guys, for coming in today. Best wishes on the show.
Thanks.
Send it back over to you guys now.
Try to grab lunch at Le Diplomat before you go. That's my piece of advice.
Or at the embassy.
Or that, too.
You might want to go to more than one place.
Okay.
They're going tonight to the embassy, right?
Yes.
Yeah, see, I said lunch today. While you're out.
McDonald's is not French?
No.
That's Le McDonald's.
Le Happy Meal.